Hi guys, this is the Hioki IR4017. This is an insulation resistance tester or IR tester. Sometimes you will hear people call an IR tester as a Megger tester, regardless of the brand. You would use the insulation tester to measure the insulation of conductors in the range of millions of ohms. So this is also called a megaohmmeter or megometer. You would use this to ensure that there is no loss of insulation on your circuit conductors for safety. If you wish to check that the insulation of your motor windings are still intact, this is the equipment for that. Its cover can go from the top to the bottom, so it doesn't get in the way. Four AA alkaline batteries provide power to the IR tester. This particular unit was manufactured in Japan in February of 2021 based on the code in its serial number, and it's rated category 3, 600 volts. This is the battery indicator. It provides you with information of the battery status at all times when you turn it on: green for good battery power, red for low battery, which means that you must replace it already, and if it fails to light up, that means that the battery has been fully drained. We must always make sure that when it is at off position, the needle pointer rests at the infinity symbol. If it does not, we can use this plastic screw to adjust it back to the infinity symbol. The lightning symbol indicator will glow red when you connect the test leads to an AC voltage source for measurement, or when you are making an insulation resistance test at 500 volts. It was shipped with a pair of test leads and one black alligator clip. The black test lead goes to the earth input terminal, while the red test lead goes to the line input terminal. The meter itself sits permanently on its hard case. You cannot remove it. They provided this space for organizing and safekeeping the test leads and the alligator clip when they are not in use. Of all the choices out there, this has to be one of the easiest and simplest. It presents you with only one insulation test range, the 500 volts DC test range with a maximum reading of 1000 mega ohm. The only other function is the AC voltage function, where it can measure AC voltage up to 600 volts. They went analog on this one. So instead of LCD, you have an analog panel. It is big and clear and easy to read. The upper scale shows the resistance reading from 0 ohm to 1000 mega ohm. The only other value there is the infinity symbol. The lower scale, the red scale, will be used for reading the AC voltage measurements. To make an insulation resistance reading, turn the selector to the 500 volts insulation test range. Press the measure key. You can also lock the key by flipping it up. This way you can take measurements one after the other without having to keep coming back to the measure key and pressing it. If you work in dim locations, you will appreciate the panel lighting. Hit this light button and watch the analog panel brighten up. Now the analog panel becomes luminous and the values are much easier to read. Before performing the insulation test, check the integrity of the test pins or the test leads by bringing them together and ensure that the needle points to the zero position. Testing for AC voltage, 237 volts. It reads AC voltage correctly. Testing the DC output voltage using the Fluke 107, DC output voltage. This is my three-phase demonstration motor. Clamping the alligator clip on the body, metallic body of the motor, I will do an insulation test between ground to line 1, ground to line 2, ground to line 3, and ground to neutral. For this demo, I will consider 100 mega ohms as the threshold. Any value above that, I will consider as good value, and below that as failed. Turning on the luminous lighting for easier reading, Battery status is good. Checking for the continuity of the test pins using the metallic body of the motor. 0 mega ohms. The test pins, the test leads are in good condition. Line 1 to ground. Mega ohms. Without removing the test pins, I will release the measure key to engage the auto discharge function. Ground to line 2. 200 mega ohms, also good. Ground to line 3. 200 mega ohms. Ground to neutral. 200 mega ohms. I have good values in this demonstration motor windings. In this next demonstration, one of the conductors in this test circuit was intentionally damaged to replicate a real-life damaged insulator in a circuit. Let's see if the insulation resistance test can detect that damage and assess the danger that it poses. Battery status is good. Test lead intact. Line 1 to line 2 insulation. That's greater than 1000 mega ohms. It's actually pointing to infinity. So that's good. Next, the metallic pipe to line 1, or ground to line 1. Also greater than 1000 mega ohms. So line 1 has good insulation. Ground to line 2. 0 mega ohms. That is a dead short. In this simple demonstration, the insulation test revealed a highly dangerous situation. If this miniature circuit breaker were energized, I would get electrocuted if I touched the metallic pipe with my bare hands. There is a serious loss of insulation in line 2 conductor. This pipe in real life situations can represent the metal enclosure of a panel board, the body of a motor, or a rigid metallic conduit. I have actually made tiny cuts in the insulation of line 2 and wrapped it in moist cloth to replicate actual water contamination. What about the price? At present, the cost of the IR4017 ranges between $260 to $330 online. I think it's quite high at this price range. I ordered my IR4017 back when it was offered at a lower price. It was a great value for me then. But at its present price range, you would really think hard about it. Or maybe just consider its competition, like the Hioki IR1456, which is a more advanced digital 5-range insulation tester. The 1456 also actually cost less than the IR4017 at their present price ranges. But price aside, there is still something about the mechanical movement of an analog meter that appeals to some of us. I'd appreciate your support. Please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe. Stay safe, and thanks for watching.